来，你准备翻译吗？有人翻译？
对，他翻译了，他翻译了一部分，有奉献者已经去聆听过了。
已经开始。
然后，但是咕噜们还没有人讲过。
没关系。因为我也讲了一部分，他们给每个人三分钟。
哦，是吗？
对。
我下午有其他的那个课程，所以没看到。
他们发了。
那今天晚上您是要再讲《梵高展开发布的荣耀》吗？还是讲布加访
谈？我们讲布加访谈，他们可以看这个 Maipur TV。看潘克江瑞的荣耀，在麦布 TV。
好的，然后我请了贾兰给曼达基周三晚上，给我们在故事会分享一些那个潘克江瑞帕布的一些逍遥时光。
什么时候？
周三，下个周三。
周三
晚上。
好。
OK， 那我们准备开始吧。
Oh. Om Jnanatimirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksurunmilitanyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Sunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vanchakaupata Rupyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Srivasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. So we're going over the life, we're hearing about the Ajamila history. Is described in the sixth canto Srimad Bhagavatam, first chapter. Haribo?
Supriyadoi Pabu, you may come back. Hare Krishna, Supriyadoi Pabu.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 能听见吗？
好了。
OK, sorry. 我们继续聆听盛典博加瓦坛第六篇关于阿加米勒的故事。
So the Yamadutas and the Vishnudutas encountered each other, and the Vishnudutas requested the Yamadutas to tell them what are the principles of religion.
Yamaduta 和 Vishnuduta 他们进行了一场辩论和谈话。Vishnuduta 问 Yamaduta, 请你告诉我们关于宗教的原则到底是什么。非宗教原则又是什么？
So the Yamadutas are describing what is their understanding of pious and impious.
所以 Yamaduta 就开始回答关于他们所理解的虔诚与不虔诚的活动。
So they describe how the living entity, every living entity in material world is connected with material nature. And so it's always difficult for them.
所以他描述到关于在这个物质世界里的生物，他们总是和物质自然属性进行联谊，所以对于他们来说总是困难重重。
Just a minute, Sati. I'm sorry. I don't want to be on the video here. Right. And, So in the human form of life, people need to be taught how to associate with the Supreme Lord and His devotees.
如果他在人体的生命形式之中，他应该被教导如何和至尊主的奉献者进行联谊。
And from that, from the teachings they get from the Lord and from His devotees, they will know how to deal with the material energy.
在得到至尊主或至尊主的奉献者的教导之后，他们可以知道怎样去处理物质自然的能量。
So the material nature is called Prakriti, means the feminine, the female energy of Krishna.
物质自然被称为 Prakriti, 意思是至尊主的阴性能量。
And the living entities in the material world, they're under the illusion that they can enjoy the material nature.
而这些生物他们处在愚昧属性之下，所以他们认为自己能够享受这些物质自然。
So because they have that desire to enjoy the material nature, they remain in the material world.
由于他们有这种想享受物质自然的渴望，所以他们得继续留在物质自然里面。
But it can change that consciousness by good association.
然而他们可以通过与很好的联谊改变他们的知觉。
They just have to take advantage. They have to learn how to take advantage of the association of the Supreme Lord or his devotees.
他们只需要利用如何恰当的，如何能够和至尊主或者至尊主的奉献者利用于他们的联谊就行。
We have to learn that the Supreme Lord Krishna is not an ordinary person, that he has a transcendental form.
我们得了解至尊主，他不是一个普通的人，他有超然的形体。
And all of his activities and pastimes are not of the material world.
所有他的活动以及他的逍遥时光都不是在这个物质世界里面。
If we understand this, then we'll be able to stay in the association of Krishna and Krishna's devotees.
如果我们能理解这一切，我们便可以稳定地处在与 Krishna 或 Krishna 奉献者的联谊之中。
When we give up the material body, we'll get a spiritual body, can go back to Godhead.
以这种知觉，当我们离开躯体的时候，我们离开这个躯体的时候，我们可以得到一个灵性的躯体。
All the living entities are eternal servants of Krishna.
所有的生物都是 Krishna 永恒的仆人。
But when we come in the material world, we become conditioned by the material nature.
当我们来到这个物质世界的时候，我们就受物质受条件，我们受条件限制。
We try to enjoy the material nature independently of Krishna.
我们想独自与 Krishna 去享受这个物质世界。
So if we want liberation, we have to give up that consciousness.
如果我们想解脱的话，我们得放弃这种知觉。
We have to become pure servants of Krishna.
我们得成为 Krishna 纯粹的仆人。
Then we can get liberation. We can go back to God.
这样我们才能够得到解脱，回归受身。
So in the beginning, this Ajamila was a Brahmana. He was born as a Brahmana, and he studied the Vedic literature.
在最开始的时候，这个阿加米勒他是一位婆罗门 Brahmana， 他学习伟达的经典。
And as a young man, he was a very good character and very good qualities.
在他年轻的时候，他是一个非常他是一个很好的年轻的男士，而且有很好的品质。
And he followed all the different injunctions of the Vedas.
他坚定地执行所有伟达的训谕。
And he was very mild and gentle. He kept his mind and senses controlled.
他温文尔雅，控制心意和感官。
And he was always truthful, and he knew how to chant Vedic mantras.
他总是诚实，而且他也知道如何唱诵伟达的曼陀罗。
And he always showed great respect to his spiritual master.And to the fire god and to the guests.
他总是尊敬他的灵性导师、火神以及客人。
And all the members, elderly members in his family, he was always respectful to them.
他也尊重他们家中的长者。
He didn't have any false ego.
他没有任何的假我。
He was very kind to all living entities and well behaved.
他也仁慈地对待一切生物体，有很好的举止。
He wasn't envious of anyone.
他也从不嫉妒任何人。
And he didn't speak nonsense.
他也从不说废话。
So this is how the Yamaduras are describing the qualities of Ajamila.
这是亚玛都塔在描述阿加米勒的年轻时候的品质。
And they're going to tell us about how Ajamila got entangled in the material world, how he became degraded.
然后他们将会描述阿加米勒是如何束缚在这个物质世界的。
So they're describing how in the beginning he was a very good scholar of the Vedas. He was well behaved. He was clean.
在这里。亚玛都塔描述到他年轻的时候，他是一个举止非常得体而且非常洁净的人。
And he's always kind to everyone.
而且他对待众生非常的友善。
He was a perfect Brahmana.
他几乎是一位完美的 Brahmana, 婆罗门。
A Brahmana is supposed to be pious and they're supposed to follow all the regulative principles and have all good qualities.
一位 Brahmana 应该非常虔诚，而且遵守所有的规范原则，有非常优良的品质。
So Ajamila followed all the rules and regulations, and he was a Brahmachari, a perfect Brahmachari.
阿加米勒遵守了所有的这些规范原则，他是一位完美的真守身。
He was soft-hearted and truthful and clean.
他的内心非常的柔软，而且真诚洁净。
So how did he fall down? He had so many good qualities. How could he fall down?
他有这么多优秀的品质，他是如何堕落的呢？
And now he's threatened with punishment. Yamaraj, the Yamaduras want to punish him.
而且他在这里受到了威胁。亚玛都塔准备想惩罚他。
So once upon a time, this Ajamila was following the order of his father, and he'd gone to the forest to collect fruit and flowers and some kinds of grass which they use, which the Brahmanas use.
有一次，这位 Brahmana 阿加米勒，他遵循父亲的命令，到森林里去采集鲜花。水果，还有一些 Brahmana 要用的特殊的草。
On the way home, he came upon there was a Sudra man, a very lusty, very low class man, and he was hugging and kissing this prostitute woman.
在他返回家的途中，他遇到了一位情欲高涨的 Sudra。这位 Sudra 非常的充满了色欲。他拥非常低阶层，他拥抱着一个妓女，而且在亲吻着这个妓女。
So this man was smiling and singing, and he was behaving like this was, he was thinking, you know, this is proper behavior. He was thinking he was enjoying.
这位苏哲笑着唱着，而且尽情地享受着，他认为这样的行为是正当的。
And both the Sudra and the prostitute were drunk.
这个 Sudra 和他搂着这个妓女都喝醉了。
And this woman, her eyes, she was so drunk that her eyes were rolling. You could see her eyes rolling due to the intoxication. And her dress, her clothing had all become loose.
这个妓女喝得两眼昏花，衣服也逐渐地松散开来。
So Ajamila saw them in like this. He saw them in this condition.
所以阿加米勒就看到了这样的情况。
So even long ago, in the past, sometimes it was seen that people would get drunk and become intoxicated, but it wasn't very common.
即便在以前，也有一些人，他们会因为喝醉酒而变得醉醺醺，麻醉。
But now in this age of Kali, you can see drunk people everywhere.
在以前这种情况不是很常见，但是在现在这当今的这个年代，我们看到这种醉醺醺的喝醉酒的到处都有。
People all over the world have no shame about these things. They think this is normal behavior.
全世界的人们都有这样的情况，而且人们并不觉得这是一个。不好，这是一个很，他们认为喝的醉醺醺是一个很恰当的行为。
So when Ajamila, remember he was a perfect Brahmana, and when he saw this couple in, like this, then he got affected. It affected his mind.
因为阿加米勒以前是一位比较完美的 Brahmana， 当他看到这样的情况，就是这个妓女和这个。书转拥抱在一起，看见这个情况的时候，他的内心受到了影响。
So today, of course, in the modern times, we can see this kind of situation everywhere.
在当今，我们看到这样的情况到处都有。
So to become a brahmachari, to be a brahmachari, and to remain steady in such a situation is not easy.
因此在这样的情况下，如果就是在这种情况下想成为一个稳定的 Brahmachari 不是很容易的一件事情。
One has to be very strong in following the regulative principles.
除非他非常强大，能够严格的遵循规范原则。
Of course, if we become Krishna conscious, if we're very serious about Krishna consciousness,then we can put up with these kind of situations.
但如果他非常认真地修习 Krishna 知觉的话，他可以抵制这样的罪恶的诱惑。
In Kali Yuga, for a man to be drunk and half naked, or for a woman to be drunk and half naked, and embracing a drunk man is not unusual.
在卡利年代，一位醉醺醺的半裸的女人拥抱一个醉汉是一个十分普遍的现象。
So, by the grace of Krishna, if we follow the regulative principles and chant the Hare Krishna mantra, then Krishna will protect the devotee.
如果一个人借着 Krishna 的仁慈，遵循规范原则，而且唱诵 Hare Krishna 的话 ，Krishna 一定会保护他。
So everybody, all devotees practicing Krishna consciousness, we have to follow very carefully the regulative principles and be very steady in chanting the holy name.
因此，所有修习 Krishna 知觉的奉献者应该严格的遵循规范原则，稳定的处在唱诵之中。
Then there will be no fear, there will be no problem. But if we don't, then it will be very dangerous.
如果他很稳定的唱诵又遵循规范原则的话，他就不需要害怕。如果他没有这样稳定的话，他就会非常的危险。
Because this is Kali Yuga, and these things are common, so we really have to protect ourselves.
因为这个是在卡利年代，这样的情况到处可见，非常普遍。我们应该非常小心保护我们自己。
So this Sudra man, he was embracing the prostitute, and Ajamila could see that the man's arm was all decorated with turmeric powder.
我们可以sorry, Gurudev.
So the Sudra man was embracing the woman, the prostitute woman.
这个 Sudra 的这个男人抱着这个妓女。
And Ajamila could see the arm of the Sudra man was all decorated with turmeric powder.
我们可以看到这个 阿加米勒他看到这个苏哲的这个男人，他 手上装饰着这个姜黄粉。
So when Ajamila saw the woman, his lusty desires woke in his heart.
当阿加米勒看到这样的情况的时候，这种色欲就在他内心泛起来了。
And because he came under the control of his lusty desires.
他变得开始无法控制他内心的色欲。
Yeah.You know, people, sometimes they put turmeric powder on the body and they say it helps to attract the lusty desires of the opposite sex.
有时人们会放上一些姜黄粉在身上，这样的情况下它就能够吸引一些异性的注意。
So this Sudra man, he had done this. He put turmeric on his arms to attract the woman.
这个梳着的这个男人，他就放了一些姜黄粉在自己的身上，想吸引这个异性。
So Ajamila tried, he was trying to remember the instructions of the Shastra, not to even look at the woman.
阿加米勒这个时候就开始想记忆 Shastra 经典中的一些东西，不看这个女人。
So remembering that,He tried to control his mind and control his lusty desires.
他想控制他内心的色欲。
But because the god of love, Cupid, was so powerful in his heart, he couldn't control his mind.
因为这个丘比特在他的内心是如此强大，他无法控制自己的色欲。
If you want to control the mind, you have to be very strong.In patience and in knowledge.
如果一个人想控制的内心的话，他必须有非常牢固的知识、忍耐力，还有知识。
If you don't have good knowledge and if you're not very patient, then it's very difficult to control the mind when you become lusty.
如果你没有牢固的知识和忍耐力的话，要控制色欲非常的困难。
So after Ajamil saw the man embracing the young prostitute woman, and he saw they were in such a, you know, the condition, they were almost on the point of having sex. So he became very disturbed.
在这个阿加米勒看到男人拥抱这个妓女之后，他们几乎是要过上这种性的这种生活，所以呢，这种情况对阿加米勒的内心来讲是一个非常大的打扰。
So although Ajamila was a good brahmana, he couldn't control his lusty desires, and he couldn't control. Go ahead.
即便阿加米勒是一个很完美的、有资格的 brahmana, 但是他无法控制自己的色欲。
So he couldn't stop himself from going after these two people.
他无法抑制他，在他，他无法抑制内心的这种冲动。
So, you see, Ajamila at this time he wasn't doing devotional service, so he didn't have the protection of Krishna.
因为阿加米勒没有做奉献服务，他所以没有得到。
So it was very difficult for him to try to control his mind and senses.
对于他来说，很难以控制他的心意和感官。
So he lost all of his good qualities, all of his good sense was lost.
他所有美好的品质以及他的感官都失去了。
Just like when there's an eclipse, sometimes when there's an eclipse, the lower planet like Rahu or Ketu, they will cover the sun or the moon.
就像在日食或月食的时候，这个很低等的星球 Rahu 星球，它跑到了前面来。
So he was Ajamila was always thinking of this woman prostitute.
所以这位阿姜弥勒总是在想着这个妓女。
So after a short time, he brought her to his home to be a servant in his house.
在很短的时间内，他就把这个妓女带到了他的家里面去当他的仆人。
And he stopped all the regulative principles of a brahmana.
他也不再遵守所有 brahmana 的这些规范原则了。
So Sukadeva Goswami is telling this, he's telling about this to Maharaj Parikshit.
Sukadeva Goswami 给 Parikshit Maharaj 讲述了这一切。
So he wants Maharaj Parikshit to understand that Ajamila's position of a brahmana was lost by his association with the prostitute.
Sukadeva Goswami 想描述的是阿加米勒因为和一位妓女的联谊，他失去了他 Brahmana 的这个崇高的地位，堕落了下来。
And he forgot all of his Brahminical activities.
他完全忘记了他所有的 Brahmana 的这些品质活动。
Of course, at the end of the life, he was saved because he chanted the holy name Narayana.
当然，在他人生结束的时候，他喊出了至尊主的圣名 Narayana.
So.A little devotional service can save one from the greatest danger.
哪怕做一点点的奉献服务，都能使人摆脱最危险的处境。
Even if someone falls down from the position of a brahmana through illicit sex, he can be saved if he somehow chants the holy name.
即便一个人从 Brahmana 的地位上堕落下来，因为这种非法的性生活堕落下来，他如果做奉献服务的话，他还能得到拯救。
This is the power of the holy name.
这是圣名的强大力量。
So nobody should forget to chant the holy name. It's the most important activity.
没有人。人不应该忘记唱诵圣名，这是非常重要的。
There's so many dangers in the material world. At any time we may fall down.
在这个物质世界有很多的危险，任何时候我们都有可能堕落。
But if we always keep ourselves pure and steady by chanting Hare Krishna mantra, then we will be safe.
如果我们能够总是稳定的、纯粹的、纯洁的唱诵 Hare Krishna mantra 的话，我们是安全的。
So Ajamila then he began spending his money which he'd got from his father. He inherited money from his father, but he began spending it all on the prostitute.
Ajamila 开始挥霍他从父亲那里继承的所有的钱财，全部把它用来取悦这个妓女。
He would give her different presents just to make her feel happy, to feel pleased with him.
他只是想，他买了一些，买各种各样的礼物，就是想取悦这个妓女。
And he gave up all of his brahminical activities to please this woman.
而且他还放弃了所有 brahmana 婆罗门所从事的活动来取悦这个妓女。
So Prabhupada said, this is not an unusual situation. This happens many times.
圣帕帕的说，这不是一个很，就是说，这是一个很普遍的例子。这样的事情经常发生。
Some man with a lot of money who is quite pure, they spend all the money on some prostitute.
有一些人很有钱，而且很纯洁，但是呢，他把所有的钱却用在一个妓女的身上。
People have such, they're so low, they're so degraded. Some people are so low that they're so eager for sex, they'll do everything to get sex.
有一些人非常的低劣，他为了这种性，他可以做一切的事情。
So that illicit sex will ruin their good character and take away their good qualities, take away all their money.
这种非法的性生活不会带来任何好的品质，而且它会把一个人所有的钱都得拿走。
So people want sex, they should get married, they should have a wife, and they can have legal sex with their wife.
如果一个人想要这种性生活的话，他应该娶一个妻子，他可以和他的妻子正常的，他可以和他妻子合法的性生活。
So Krishna conscious grihasthas, they should be happy together, husband and wife. They shouldn't go looking for some illicit connection.
Krishna 知觉的这些居士们应该永远记住，他们应该满足于对方，不要去找别的人。
And they should be peaceful by chanting the Hare Krishna mantra.
他们应该通过唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗而变得平和。
Otherwise, any moment they can fall down from their position, just like Ajamila.
否则的话，任何时候他们都有可能从他们的地位上堕落下来，就像阿加米勒一样。
And so Ajamila, we heard he was as a Brahmana, he was intelligent, he had a good brain, but his intelligence was ruined by the association of the prostitute woman.
我们看到阿加米勒，他是一个 Brahmana, 一个很好的 Brahmana, 但是他由于和这个和妓女的联谊，他 Brahmana 的品质没了。
And Ajamila engaged in many sinful activities in her association.
因为和这个妓女的联谊，阿加米勒也从事了很多的罪恶活动。
And he gave up the company of his own young wife, who was very beautiful.
他甚至放弃了他年轻美貌的妻子的陪伴。
And she had come from a very respectable Brahmana family.
而且他的妻子甚至是来自于尊敬的 Brahmana 家庭之中。
But Ajamila took this association with the prostitute woman.
但是阿加米勒就是和这个妓女联谊在一起。
So it's common for the son to get the property of the father. When the father leaves the body, the son will inherit his property.
人们是有资格去继承，就是说儿子是有资格去继承父亲的财产。
But you see what happened when he got the money, he didn't use it for the service of Krishna. He used it for the service of the prostitute.
我们看到他用这个钱干了些什么，他并没把这个钱用来服务 Krishna, 但是却用来服务这个妓女。
So therefore, he should have been punished by Yamaraj.
因此他应该受到 Yamaraj 的惩罚。
Because he'd fallen under the control of the lusty glances of the prostitute.
因为他成了妓女危险色眯眯瞥视的牺牲品。
So because of this prostitute's association, whenever Ajamil got any money, then it would be used to maintain the prostitute's children.
因为和这个妓女的联谊，阿加米勒无论有钱的什么时候有钱，他都把这个钱用来维系妓女和他的孩子。
So sometimes Ajamil, he would do things illegal, sometimes he would steal like that just to get money to give to this prostitute so she could maintain her children.
有时他甚至去偷，用一些不正当的方法把这些拿到的钱来维系这个妓女和他的孩子们。
So although Ajamila was a Brahmana and he had a long life, but he didn't follow any of the rules and regulations of the scriptures.
这位阿加米勒，他生活的时间很长，但是他后面完全没有遵循这些规范原则。
And he would eat the food prepared by this prostitute.
他吃这个妓女准备的食物。
Therefore, he was carrying a lot of sinful reactions.
这样他就带着身上带着各种带着很多的罪恶活动的反报应。
And he was not clean anymore, and he was addicted to all kinds of sinful activities.
他也不再洁净，而且从事了很多的罪恶活动。
So if you eat food which is cooked by somebody who is not clean, either a man or a woman, especially if she's a prostitute, then it's very, very infectious, very bad.
如果我们吃一个不洁净的人所做的这个食物，不论他是男的还是女的，特别是如果他是一位妓女的话，这个食物是非常非常糟糕的。
So Ajamila ate that food, so he should have been punished by the Yamaraj.
阿加米勒吃了这样的食物，因此他要受到 Yamaraj 的惩罚。
So this Ajamila, he didn't do any atonement for all of his sins.
这个阿加米勒甚至没有做任何的忏悔活动，对于他的罪恶活动没有做任何的忏悔。
So the Yamadutas say, because of his sinful life, we have to take him to see Yamaraj to be punished.
Yamadutta 就说，由于他罪恶的一生，我们得把这个阿加米勒带到 Yamaraj 那里去接受惩罚。
And Yamaraj will know how much punishment he should get, and in this way he will get purified.
Yamaraj 知道他得受到多大程度的惩罚，在这之后他会得到净化。
So the servants of Lord Vishnu, they told the Yamadutas not to take Ajamila to Yamaraj.
Vishnu Dutta 告诉 Yamadutta 不要把阿加米勒带到 Yamaraj 那里去。
But the Yamaduras, they're arguing, no, he should go to Yamaraj, he has to be punished.
但是 Yamadutta 就反对起来，他说不，我们应该把这个阿加米勒带到 Yamaraj 那去接受惩罚。
Because Ajamila didn't do any atonement, he didn't do anything to make up for all of his sins.
因为阿加米勒根本没有为他的罪行做任何的忏悔。
He was supposed to go to Yamaraj to be purified.
He 应该去到 Yamaraj 那里得到净化。
Right? Purification would be painful by punishment.
通过惩罚，他能够得到净化。
Just like when a man is a murderer, if he kills someone, so that's very sinful. He has to also be punished.
就像一个谋杀犯，他如果杀了人的话，他是很罪恶的，他应该接受惩罚。
And because he's a murderer, he should be killed himself. Otherwise, next life he will suffer more.
因为他是一位谋杀犯，所以他应该也被处死，否则的话，在下一生他会遭受更多的痛苦。
So that's stated in the Manu Samhita.That the murderer should be hung.
这个在 Manu Samhita 中得到确认，一个谋杀犯他应该被处以吊死或绞死。
So to get punished by Yamaraj is how we get purified.
这个阿加米勒如果去到 Yamaraj 那的话，他会得到净化。
So the Yamadutas are telling the Vishnu Dutas.That we have to take Ajamila there to Yamaraj.
Yamadutta 就告诉Vishnu Dutta，我们应该带他到 Yamaraj 那里去。
But the servants of Lord Vishnu are very expert in logic and argument.
但是主威士努的仆人非常擅长于逻辑和辩论。
So after they heard what the Yamadutas say,They reply to everything. They're going to reply to everything the Yamadutas say.
当威士努都塔听到 Yamadutta 的谈话说话之后，他们将如下回答。
So the first thing the Vishnu Dutas say is, "Oh, it's very painful for us to see that irreligion is being introduced here."Where people are supposed to be religious.
Vishnu Dutta 说，非宗教如果被引进到维持宗教的公堂上，这是非常令人痛苦的。
You people are supposed to be in charge of maintaining the religious principles.
你们这些人应该是维持宗教原则的人。
But you want to punish a sin, a, a, a person who has no sins. You shouldn't be punished.
但是你们不应该去惩罚一位无罪的人，他不应该受到惩罚。
So the Vishnu Duttas are telling the Yama Duttas that you're wrong to try to take Ajamila to Yamaraj.
Vishnu Dutta 在这里指责 Yamaraj， 你们做错了，把这个阿杰米勒带到 Yamaraj 这来，你们错了。
Yamaraj is appointed by Krishna to judge people who's sinful and who's not.
Yamaraj 被主 Krishna 指定，告诉谁是罪恶的，谁是应该受到惩罚的。
But if somebody who is sinless, if somebody who is sinless is punished, then everybody who is in connection with Yamaraj will be contaminated with the reactions.
但是如果一个丝毫无罪的人受到惩罚，那么整个 Yamaraj 的公堂就会，整个 Yamaraj 的这个公堂就会受到污染。
So this is true not only in Yamaraj's assembly, but wherever there are human beings.
这个原则不仅适用于 Yamaraj 的公堂上，还适用于整个人类社会。
The human beings, they're responsible. They get karma, they get punished. They can do sinful or pious activities. The animals, they cannot.
在人类社会中，我们有职责去维护宗教原则，但是动物它是不行的。
So it's the duty of the government or the king, the ruler of a country like the king or the government, their duty is to make sure that religious principles are properly maintained.
一个国王或者一个政府。他们的职责是维护宗教原则恰当的执行。
But in this Kali Yuga, we see that people they've ruined the religious principles. They don't know what are the real religious principles.
但是在这个卡利年代，我们看到他们混乱的这个宗教，我们根本就看不到宗教原则。
The government don't know who is to be punished and who is not.
我们这个政府他们根本不知道谁应该受到惩罚，谁不应该受到惩罚。
Sometimes people say, unless you have a lot of money, if you go to court, you won't get justice.
在现在这个年代，如果不在法庭上倾注金钱的话，就很难得到公正。
We often see in the court sometimes the judges that they take bribes so that people can get the verdict they want.
我们看到现在法院里面，如这个人如果贿赂这个官员的话，他就可以得到他想要的判决。
And sometimes devotees who are preaching Krishna consciousness get arrested, and they're taken to by the police, and they have to go to court.
但是我们现在看到有一些奉献者，他传播 Krishna 知觉却被带到了法庭上，被逮捕了。
They have to pay fines. They're told that they've been doing something against the law and they have to pay a fine.
由于他们骚扰了这个法律，或者他们没有遵守法律，或者说怎么样，他们得付钱，罚款。
So the servants of Lord Vishnu are devotees, so they are very sorry about these situations.
Vishnu Dutta, 他们也是主 Vishnu 的仆人，这些 Vaishnava 也是主 Vishnu 的仆人，他们为这些事情感到非常的悲悯同情。
So they feel compassion on the fallen souls, and they go around preaching. They try to preach Krishna consciousness.
Vaishnava 对这些事情，对这些堕落的灵魂感到同情，同时他们去传播 Krishna 知觉。
But because the influence of Kali Yuga is so strong, sometimes they get harassed and even get punished, and taken to court with false charges.
但是由于卡利年代的影响实在太强大了，所以他们经常容易受到骚扰，而且被指控带到法庭，就是被逮捕逮捕。
Sometimes they will say, "You people are disturbing the peace. You're making so much noise."
有一些人就控告这个奉献者说，你们打扰了和平和宁静，你们制造了太多的噪音。
And when you go on the streets doing sankirtan, you beat your drums and play the cymbals, you disturb everybody.
你们去街上做 sankirtan 的时候，你们打着你们的鼓，而且敲锣打鼓的，你们打扰了人们。
But we see there's so many big trucks, there's so many buses, they also make a lot of noise, they also disturb people.
但是我们也看到街上那么多的车，他们在这个马路上的时候不停地按喇叭，也打扰着人们。
But they don't mind about these people, they only harass the devotees.
但是他们不管这些车上按喇叭的人，他们只想去抓这些奉献者。
So somebody who is the king or the ruler or the government of a country, they have to be very qualified.
一位国王或者一个行政长官应当非常具有资格才行。
They have to be able to act as a protector of the citizens.
他们应当成为居民的保护者。
And they should have feelings of affection and love for all the citizens, for all the people in their country.
他们应当平等地对待众生，给予他们爱。
They should be able to give the citizens good advice and instructions.
他们应当给予这些老百姓正确的训示。
Right? It should guide them according to the scriptures.
应当从经典上指导他们。
It should be equal to everyone.
应当平等地对待所有的人。
So Lord Yamaraj, he does this. He is the master of justice.
Yamaraj, 他做到了这一点。他是公平的主人。
And anybody who follows in the footsteps of Yamaraj, they have to also do like that.
那些追随 Yamaraj 脚步的人也是这样做的。
But if people become polluted, if we become contaminated, and we start to punish innocent people who have no fault, then this is very bad.
然而，如果这些人，就是这些掌管者、这些司法者或政府去惩罚清白无辜的人，他们。这是非常不好的事情。
Then the people in the country, they have nobody to look to for their safety or for their protection.
这些没有罪恶的人受到了惩罚，那所有的老百姓将去哪里寻求保护？
So the government and the king, their job is to teach people the proper goal of life.
国王和政府应该告诉人们生命的目标。
We should be able to realize our own spiritual identity.
我们应该觉悟人生的主要的，我们自己的身份。
And then we should go on to realize our relationship with the Supreme Lord.
接着，我们应该觉悟到我们自己和至尊主的关系。
Animals cannot understand these things. This is the duty of human beings.
动物是不可能觉悟到这一些的，只有人才有这个职责去觉悟这一些。
And the government have to train the citizens in such a way that they will come to the spiritual platform.
政府有职责训练臣民，逐渐提升到这种灵性的层面。
You know, not quickly, but gradually. It has to be a gradual process that people will gradually come to the spiritual platform.
不是说立刻就提升到这种层面， 逐渐地训练他们提升到灵性的层面。
And they'll realize their set, who they are in their relationship with Krishna.
觉悟到他们自己是谁，以及他们和神的关系。
And so in the Vedic culture, there were great kings who did this. Kings like Maharaj Yudhisthira, Maharaj Parikshit, and Lord Rama.
在伟大的经典之中，有很多的人，很多伟大的国王都做到这一点，比如说 Yudhisthira Maharaj, Maharaj Parikshit 和 Rama, 主 Rama Chandra,
Maharaj Ambarish, Prahlad Maharaj,
Maharaj Ambarish 以及 Prahlad Maharaj.
And of course the leaders of the government have to be very honest and religious also.
同样的政府部门应该非常的诚实可信，以及具有宗教心。
If they don't have these qualities, then the affairs of the state will be affected, and it will not be easy to keep the state organized.
如果他们不能做到这样的话，国家的事务将会受到损害，而且不稳定。
So we see in democratic countries, we get so many rogues and thieves becoming the rulers.
我们看到在民主的名义下有很多恶棍和盗贼成为这个国家的掌管者或者统治者。
People who are rogues and thieves, they will elect other bigger rogues and thieves to be their leaders.
一个恶棍和盗贼，他会让更大的恶棍和盗贼成为这个更大的统治者。
So we have seen this in different countries. Sometimes the people have to get rid of the leader because he's found to be very bad, very corrupt. And the people have to pull him down and get rid of him.
So the people have to pull him down and get rid of him.
And they try to take all the money for themselves, all the country's money, they want to put it in their own pocket. So, Krishna consciousness devotees, they shouldn't vote for anyone who is not Krishna conscious.
Krishna 知觉的奉献者不应该选举没有 Krishna 知觉的人成为这个统治者。
The only people we can vote for are devotees.
我们应该选举奉献者作为统治者。
And then we will get peace, and then there will be prosperity also in the country.
这样我们的国家就会有平和与繁荣。
So when a Vaishnava sees how the government's not managing properly, he feels very sorry.
当一个 Vaishnava 看到政府管理者没有恰当的去管理着，他感觉到极大的悲伤和同情。
And he tries to do his best to help people by chanting the holy name everywhere.
因此他通过唱诵去在全世界各地帮助人们。
OK, so we'll stop here today.
好，我们今天讲到这儿。
Any questions?
Yes.First question from 静心瑜伽顶拜咕噜既然阿迦弥勒是如此完美的婆罗门与真守身是什么原因让他没有能控制自己的心意所带来的影响呢难道之前所有的好品质与知识掺杂的水分吗难道他没有牢固的知识与稳定的控制力吗是玛雅与丘比特的能量太强大了还是阿迦弥勒本身色欲是隐藏起来的如果他没有为主做服务那怎么又能称得上是如果他没有为主做服务他怎么又能称得上是一个真守身于婆罗门呢 真守身于婆罗门是主的奉献者吗？感恩老师。Here are many questions. Okay.
Okay, one by one.
Yeah, yes. First, obeisance to Guru. Since Ajamila is the so perfect Brahmana and Brahmachari, why he can't control his mind, the influence of his mind? This is first.
Okay. Well, if you read the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna describes there, any one of the senses can carry away the intelligence of a man who's trying to control his senses.
如果我们读博伽梵歌的话，我们可以看到任何 any way of good day. I can't hear that word.
Any one of the senses, any one of our five senses can carry to take away a man's intelligence.
一个有智性的人，他任何一个感官都有可能会被掳走。
Just like Vishwamitra, he was a very powerful yogi and he was doing austerities. But Menaka came, a beautiful woman came, and he forgot all about his meditation and he became entangled with this woman.
就像 Vishwamitra, 他正在做着冥想。他当他冥想，当这个时候就有一位漂亮的女性来了。当这个漂亮的女性一来的时候，她所有的就全忘了。她开始想着这个女人。
And the result was a child was born. And after the child was born, then Vishwamitra remembered that he was supposed to be doing meditation and austerities.
接着，他和这个女人就产下了一个孩子。当这个小孩子产下之后，他才开始回想起。他原本应该从事冥想和苦行的。
So he had to go back. He left them again. He left this woman with a baby, and he went back to his meditation again to try again.
因此，他就离开了这个女人和这个孩子，然后继续回到那里去冥想。
You have to understand the material energy is Krishna's energy is very powerful, and it can attract anyone.
我们得理解 Krishna 的这个能量是非常强大的，它可物质能量是非常强大的，它可以吸引任何一个人。
Lord Shiva is a very powerful personality. He's far above the position of a Brahmana. Lord Shiva is like God. But even he became attracted to the form of Krishna in a woman when Krishna came as Mohini Murti.
即便是主 Shiva。他也受到了影响，他被主 Krishna 的 Mohini 的这个形象给吸引了。
And Lord Brahma is the first Brahmana. He's the first Brahmana. He got Brahmana initiation from Krishna, but he became attracted to his own daughter.
即便是主 Brahma， 他是第一位 Brahma， 他被他自己的女儿。
So don't be surprised when somebody falls down.
因此，不要感觉到惊讶。当有人如果堕落的话，不要感觉到惊讶。
We should be surprised that somebody doesn't fall down.
我们应该感到惊讶的是那些没有堕落的人。
Next question.
Yes. 难道之前所有的好品质与知识掺杂的水分吗？Is that all the good quality and the knowledge that mix with other things? He wants to know whether Ajamila's all the good quality and good qualities and the knowledge are mixed with water.
Mixed with what?
Are not pure.
Oh.Its good qualities are not pure. Well,
yeah, good qualities and knowledge are not pure.
Well, they were pure. He was pure, but he became contaminated.
他之前的好品质是纯洁的，但是呢，后来受到了污染。
When he saw the couple embracing, it awakened lusty desires.
当他看到这个两个这个伴这个两个人在一起拥抱的时候，他的色欲就出来了。
So the good qualities couldn't protect him.
因此他的好品质没有保护他，好品质不能保护他。
Go ahead.
Yes. Next question is, 难道他没有牢固的知识与稳定的控制？ Whether this Ajamila have the strong knowledge and the steady controlling?
He had some knowledge and he had some control, but he lost it in the association of the prostitute.
他有知识，他有牢固的知识，他也有控制力，但是当他和妓女联谊的时候，他失去了。
As we heard, he brought her to his home, and he began to associate with her, and he began to do sinful things with her.
我们今天听到了，他把这个妓女带回了家之后，他
He brought her to his home, and he began to do sinful activities together.
他把这个妓女带回去之后，他就开始从事罪恶活动了。两个人一起从事罪恶活动。Is that Maya and the cubit, the energy of Maya and the cubit so powerful, or is Ajamila his last is?Hide inside.
His love is hiding inside.
His lust.
Oh, his lust. Yes. Well.
Yeah.
Yes. Lust can be awakened as soon as we forget Krishna, and we forget about. You see, Ajamila. You have to understand. Ajamila was a brahmana, but he was not a devotee.
We know Ajamila is a brahmana.是一位婆罗门，但是他并不是一位奉献者。
He hadn't learned about devotional service.
他没有学习奉献服务。
He didn't know about the power of chanting the holy name.
他不知道，他没有学习到唱诵圣名的力量。
He just knew about brahminical qualities, and he was worshipping Shaligram, doing things like that.
他只有一些 Brahmana 的这些活动，比如说崇拜 Shanagram Sila。
He was a Brahmana, but he was not a Vaishnava.
他是一位 Brahmana, 但是他不是一位 Vaishnava.
So, he was a victim of the material energy in the form of Cupid and Maya.
因此他是物质自然比如说玛雅或丘比特能量的牺牲品。
Yes.
Yes. If he didn't do the service to the Lord, why he can be called as a brahmachari or brahmana?
A brahmana and a brahmachari may not be devotees.
一位真守生或者婆罗门并不一定是奉献者。
Brahmana and Brahmachari, these are positions in the Varnashram. But the Varnashram is not just only for devotees. There are people who are not devotees, they are also in Varnashram, following Varnashram.
真守生也好，婆罗门也好，只是社会四阶层和宁静四阶段的这个里面的身份。还有一些人他不是奉献者，但他也在社会四阶层与灵性四阶段的这个身份里面。
So you have to understand that there are people who may be brahmanas, but they may be materialistic. They may have no devotion for Krishna.
你得理解，如果有一些人有可能他是一个婆罗门，但他有可能并不是一位奉献者，他对 Krishna 没有奉爱之心。
And similarly, brahmacharis, they may have no devotion for Krishna.
同样的，一个真守身有可能也对 Krishna 没有什么分外之心。
They're just simply practicing celibacy. They don't practice devotion.
他有可能只是在练习真守的方式，但是他并没有从事奉献服务。
下一个问题。
下一个问题 ，Yujangsa answered。他的问题是：真守身于婆罗门是主的奉献者吗 ？Does Brahmachari and Brahmana are the Lord devotees？
No, they're not necessarily. They may be devotees, but they may not.
真守身和婆罗门有可能是奉献者，有可能不是奉献者。
There are different kinds of Brahmins and Brahmacharis.
有不同种类的 Brahmachari 和婆罗门。
Some are materialists, and some are Mayavadis, and some are devotees.
有一些是奉献者，有一些是物质主义者，还有一些是非人格主义者，都有。
Some of them just worship demigods. They think all the gods are the same.
有一些人甚至崇拜，有一些他们这些人甚至崇拜半神，他们认为所有的神都是一样的。
还有问题吗
？Yes, this is from Yuna Mataji. Yuna Mataji ask, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. Can followers of the of other confessions after death go to heaven or higher planes? Can they develop Krishna consciousness on these planes, or are they returning to the earth again? Thank you. All glory to Srila Prabhupada.
Can you read it again?
Yes. Can followers of other confessions after death go to heaven or higher planes? Can they develop Krishna consciousness on this planet, or are they returning to earth again?
Okay.
Are two questions here.
So, Chinese.
Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj, 请接受我卑微的顶拜。这confessions 呢？
其他的宗教
就是在其他的宗教的追随者在他们死后能去到天堂或者高等的星球吗 ？This is the first question.
Yes, they can go somewhere in the material world. They can go to higher planets like heaven. Yeah.
是的，他们有一些是可以去到天堂星球。
They may even go to the kingdom of God. They may go into the spiritual world if they have the mood to be the servant.
如果他们有对神的仆人的心态、服务的心态的话，他们甚至有可能能去到灵性世界，会去到神的国度。第二个问题是，他们能够发展出 Krishna 知觉在。这些星球吗？或者他们会再一次回到地球
？Well, if they're going to take to Krishna consciousness, they have to get the association of a devotee.
如果他们想发展 Krishna 知觉的话，他们得和奉献者联谊。
They cannot become Krishna conscious on their own.
他们不能一个人发展出 Krishna 知觉。
They have to meet with devotees and get some association and.Be inspired and directed how to practice bhakti yoga.
他们得遇到奉献者，然后在他们的指导之下，如何练习 bhakti yoga 奉爱瑜伽。
They may go. Yeah, if they go to heaven, they will enjoy there for a long time, and then they will come back.
是的，当他们如果去到天堂星球的话，他们会在那里享受很长的时间，然后再次回来。
Come back to Earth. This Earth planet, this is the place where people earn their karma.
这个地球是人们挣取业报的地方。
So they come here to get karma, to see where they're going to go.
他们在这里获得业报，然后去到时候看他们到底应该去到哪里。
OK
Yes 进行瑜伽说谢谢老师。 Next question from 小鱼，对所有人，小鱼 Hare Krishna， 顶拜所有的奉献者，请问 Maharaj， 阿加米勒的堕落是因为没有严格修行吗？还是说做了冒犯才导致堕落呢？ Hare Krishna， basis to all devotees， I want to ask Maharaj， the fallen of Ajahn Mila， does he because of he didn't practice very strict， or he did some offense， then he become fallen？
You have to understand， he wasn't practicing bhakti yoga， so he fell。
你得理解到他是没有从事奉爱服务，奉爱瑜伽，所以才堕落了。
He was doing some rituals, he was following the Vedas, but he was not cultivating bhakti.
他做了伟大的仪式，做了伟大的这些活动，但是他并没有培养出奉爱。
He was not offensive, but he was sinful.
他并没有冒犯，但是他是罪恶。
Yeah, he did a lot of sins. He left his wife to go with the prostitute.
他做了很多的罪恶活动，比如说他和一个妓女在一起，甚至抛弃了自己的妻子。
And he would do a lot of illegal things, sometimes stealing to get money to give to the prostitute.
而且他还做了很多不合法的事情，比如说偷钱来维系自己的，维系这些妓女和他的孩子们。
And so these were sinful things.
这些是一些罪恶的活动。
But there was no offense.
但是并不是冒犯的。
So he fell down because he didn't have the shelter of Lord Krishna's lotus feet.
他之所以堕落是因为他没有得到 Krishna 的庇护。
Krishna says his devotee will never perish. Krishna protects the devotee.
Krishna 说他的奉献者永不毁灭， Krishna 保护他的奉献者。
So Ajamila's problem came because he didn't have the shelter of Lord Krishna.
但是阿加米勒他并没有得到 Krishna 的庇护。
He had a guru, but his guru was not a devotee.
他有他的灵性导师，但是他的灵性导师也不是一个奉献者。
So he didn't have a qualified guru.
因此他没有一个有资格的灵性导师。
Okay.
Next question from Tom. 顶拜 Guru Maharaj, Swami 和 Goswami 是控制感官的意思。这两个称呼是 Vaishnava 独有，还是婆罗门也可以有？ Swami and Goswami is that, it means controlling the mind.So these two name is from the Vaishnava or the Brahmana also can have these two name.
Yes, not only Vaishnavas have these names. There are many people who have these names.
不仅仅是 Vaishnava 有这个名字，很多人都有这两个名字。
We say usually the sannyasis. The sannyasis, they have the name Swami or Goswami.
我们听到 Swami, 通常我们听到的是那些 sannyasi, 他们的称呼是 Swami 或 Goswami.
So sannyasis can be devotees and they may also not be devotees.
Sannyasi, no devotee or devotee.
Sannyasis may be...可能有的圣亚西是奉献者，有的圣亚西不是奉献者。
有的圣亚西是奉献者，有的圣亚西还不是奉献者。
And some sannyasis they just worship demigods.
有一些圣亚西甚至他们崇拜半神人。
And some sannyasis don't worship anybody, they just worship themselves.
有一些圣亚西甚至不崇拜任何人，他们只崇拜他自己。
So there are many different kinds of sannyasis.
有很多不同种类的三利亚西。
And some are called Swami and some are called Goswami.
有一些被称为 Swami, 有一些被称为 Goswami.
下一个问题。
下一个问题 from Das. 阿加米勒没有做奉爱服务就得到了 Vishnu 的仁慈，有点不可思议吧？这和只有通过奉爱服务才能得到仁慈是矛盾的吧？阿加米勒 didn't do any devotional service, but he got the Vishnu's mercy. Is kind of incredible. And is also unbelievable that only devotional service can get the mercy.
So why do you say Ajamil did not do devotional service? Who is?
你为什么说阿加米勒没有做奉爱服务呢？
Remember, Ajamil was chanting the name of Narayan.
我们听到阿加米勒他唱了 Narayana 的名字。
Even though he didn't chant the name of God, he was chanting his son's name, and it was the name of the Supreme Lord.
即便他没有唱诵主的名字，他唱诵了儿子的名，即便他没有唱。没有想的是唱诵主的名字，他唱诵的是儿子的名字，但是这个名字还是主的名字。
So he was doing devotional service without knowing it. He didn't know he was doing it.
因此他做了奉献服务，但是他是没有意识的情况下做了奉献服务。
真的是不可思议的。
这是不可思议的。
Yeah, inconceivable, right? This is inconceivable.
Inconceivable,
but devotional service can be done like that without people don't know they're doing it. They get the benefit.
但是奉献服务就是这样的，人们即便是不知道他这样做也是有益处的。
The benefit is it destroys sinful reactions.
这个益处就是它能摧毁罪恶反应。
We'll hear as we go on in the chapter. You'll hear more.
我们将会越多的聆听到这个的。
下一个问题。
Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。
对，我有一个问题，刚才打字打了一半，没打上来。就是在这个六十五世节当中，说这个阿加弥勒的智力受到妓女瞥视的这个刺破，然后作为受害者，他从事各种罪恶活动。那么我想问 Gurudev。就是智力不是高于感官和心意吗？然后这里怎么能够就是这个智力受到这个感官对象和感官的这个影响成为他的受害者呢？
He said in the verse 65, he said, it said that the intelligence were harmed by theglimpse of the prostitute. So Satyamataji asked, the intelligence is higher than the sense. Why this intelligence can be contaminated by this lower sense?
Well, remember, in Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna describes the nature of lust. That lust is found in the senses and in the mind and in the intelligence.
我们在《薄伽梵歌》中记得主 Krishna 怎么样描述这个色欲的，色欲在人的智性之中，也在人们的心意之中。
So intelligence can also be contaminated by lusty desires.
所以一个人的色欲也会被，一个人的智性也会被色欲给污染。
The senses, when he allowed the senses to become contaminated, to engage in sinful activities, then gradually his mind also became contaminated, and then the contamination spread also to his intelligence.
当他的智性如果允许他去做这个罪恶活动的话，他就污染了他的心，污染了他的这个心，又反过来去污染他的这个智性。
So Prabhupada was explaining in the purports that we have to cultivate the intelligence to be able to defeat this lust when it awakens in the heart.
圣帕帕德就在要旨中说, 我们应该培养这种, we should cultivate the intelligence to defeat this lust.
Yes.
我们应该培养这种智性去击败这种色欲。
How can we overcome this lust?
我们如何克服色欲呢? 能够征服这个色欲呢?
We have to develop a higher taste for devotional service.
我们得发展出 高等的品位, 在奉爱服务之中发展出更高的品位才行。
Right. If we've experienced a higher taste, we're getting great pleasure in devotional service, we won't be attracted to this lust.
如果我们在奉爱服务中发展出高等的品位, 我们不会被这种色欲的东西所吸引。
And the other thing is by good philosophical intelligence, that we can defeat the desire for sense gratification.
另外一个就是牢固的智性可以击败这个色欲。
We should think that sense gratification which we are desiring, that is the pleasure of animals which eat stool like the dogs and the pigs.
我们得理解到觉悟到 那些感官享乐是那些吃屎的猫啊狗啊猪啊是他们的感官享乐。
Do you want to have the same pleasure as the pigs which eat stool?
你想和这个猪一样跟它有一样的感官的快乐吗?
So intelligent people will not want that kind of pleasure.
一个有智性的人不会想要那种快乐。
And they will give up that thought for lusty sense gratification. Sati, 明白吗?
是的，是的，Guru。 但是为什么说他是这个受害者呢? 就是他把这个妓女的这个瞥视 强调的是很有力量， 成为他的这个瞥视的受害者。
受害者是什么意思?
受害者，牺牲品。 等一下。 harm, be harmed by the prostitute.
Oh, okay, yeah. So how did Ajamil get harmed by the, why did he allow himself to become harmed by the prostitute? Sati, 这个是在什么地方?
第65节, 65.
No, 不是65节, 他说, yeah, 65, yeah, huh?
65节.
65节.
对,第一章。
Oh, the Ijang.
Verse
1.
Yeah.
Chapter 1. Verse 6.
Victim.
The Ijang.
是的,第一章.
Lushu.
是.
Okay, 我看啊. Okay, 明白啊. Because his intelligence was pierced by the lustful glance of the prostitute, the victimized Brahmana Ajamil engaged in sinful acts in her association. Because his intelligence was pierced by the lusty glance of the prostitute. So, Nidavanti Shishama, Weshama?
Why called Ajamila as a victim?
The victimized Brahmana Ajamil.
Yeah.
The victimized Ajamil engaged in, okay. Why is Ajamil victim? Well, he's a victim of lust.
He is a victim of lust.
Right, he's a victim of his own senses, his uncontrolled senses, his weak mind. So this is Ajimyo, why he engaged in sinful acts. You could say he was also victimized, he was also he was a victim due to bad association because he took the association of that prostitute. He himself punished himself. Because he took that woman in and he began to associate with her. It happens very easily. It's not something unique. There are many, many cases. Everywhere.
这不是什么特殊的事情, 这样的事情, 经常容易发生。
In ISKCON, we have lost many sannyasis in this way.
在我们的这个 ISKCON, 有很多 sannyasi 都通过这个离开了, 因为这样的事情离开了。
They became a victim of association with the opposite sex.
他们成为受害者或者牺牲品, 这种非法性生活的受害者或者牺牲品。
Yes, Guru Maharaj, I understand. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Shaigavati, hi Yoma.
Yes, also from this 静心瑜伽, 所以这是通过阿加米勒的故事告诉我们, 只要我们任何活动都与主有关系，都可以受到庇护，是吗？ 哪怕仅仅是在毫不知情的情况下念的一个有关 Krishna 的名字和声音，也可以免除惩罚，是吗？ 这只是为了强调圣名与 Krishna 知觉的重要性吗？ 感恩Guru. Also, three part. So this from this Ajamila story. Is that means to tell us if we do the activities that connected with the Lord, then we can get shelter by the Lord.
Yes, that's true.
这是对的, 我们是会被受到庇护。
If you're connected to Krishna by devotional service, then you have his shelter, and Krishna takes care of his devotees.
如果我们从事奉爱活动与 Krishna 有关的话, 我们会得到 Krishna 和他奉献者的庇护。
But don't take advantage, don't be foolish.
但是不要利用这一点, 也不要变得愚蠢。
Don't think you can just go and do anything and associate anywhere and Krishna will save you.
不要想着我可以在任何情况下, Krishna 都会 做任何的, 我可以去从事任何其他的事情, 然后Krishna就来拯救我。
Don't think you can be like Ajamila and go and associate with a prostitute and Krishna will save you.
也不要想着你要去模仿阿加米勒, 你去和一个妓女联谊, 然后Krishna来拯救你。
You are meant to be Krishna's servant, not that Krishna's your servant.
我们应该想的是我们要成为Krishna的仆人, 而不是Krishna成为我们的仆人。
The argument is...
Okay.
The argument is what?
第二个问题是, 哪怕仅仅是在, is that means we didn't know anything about devotional service, but we chant the one syllable of the Hare Krishna. That means we can not be punished
Well,
can be free of the punishment.
Well, that depends. Depends on the quality of your chanting.
这个取决于你唱诵的品质。
Chanting one syllable of the Maha Mantra, it may help you. It may.
念诵的一个 Hare Krishna 的 mantra 的一个音节可能会帮助你。
It may destroy some sins at the time of death.
在临死之前，或许也会摧毁一些罪恶的反应。
But if after chanting the holy name, if after chanting a syllable of the mantra, you go and do sinful activities, then it's not going to help you.
但是如果你唱诵了 Hare Krishna mantra, 然后或者说唱诵了其中一个音节，然后你从事罪恶的，接着就开始从事罪恶的活动的话，这样的唱诵并不能帮助你。
You have to understand, Ajamila was chanting the holy name, but he didn't think he was chanting the holy name. He was not aware that he was chanting the holy name.
我们看这个阿加米勒，他在唱诵圣名的时候，他甚至没有意识到他在唱诵圣名。
But if you think you'll chant the holy name to counteract sinful activities, then that's offense.
但是如果你唱诵圣名的是想着去中和你的罪恶反应的话，这是一种冒犯。
Krishna doesn't like that kind of chanting.
Krishna 并不喜欢这种唱诵。
You won't get any benefit from that kind of chanting.
你不会从这样的唱诵之中得到任何的益处。
And the third question?
The third question is that this story want you emphasize this holy name and Krishna consciousness is significant.
Yes, right. We want to, this pastime is to emphasize the chanting of the holy name and the power of Krishna consciousness. Very true.
是的，这个故事就是为了强调圣名与 Krishna 知觉的重要性，这是真实的。
This is a true story. This is not some myth. This is actually true.
这是一个真实的故事，而不是什么其他的，这是真实的。
But it happened long ago.
但是很早以前发生的。
还有问题吗？
Yes, from SG 顶拜孤儿和翻译及所有奉者，请问灵性四阶层和灵性四阶段都是物质的吗？两者有任何关系吗？比如婆罗门能上升到萨尼亚西吗？感恩孤儿。 Obeisances to Guru, I want to ask the spiritual the Varna Ashram, is that material?
The Varna Ashram is, yes, material.
One ashram 是物质的，就是灵性四阶段、社会四阶层和社会四阶段是物质的。社会四阶层和灵性四阶段，does what's the relationship between the varna and ashram?
Well, the ashrams are divided according to age, like young men.They begin the life up to 25 or 30, practice brahmachari life usually, and then go into grihastha life. And in grihastha life, they will take up some varna because they have to support their family.
This varna, this ashram, is a stage, it is based on age. For example, in brahmachari, it is 20 years old.30岁以前做这个真守僧，然后到居士，然后再慢慢的到这个行脚僧，然后这是根据年龄的划分的。
And then, after 50, over 50, then it's time to retire and vanaprastha, and you should stop working and you should concentrate on spiritual activities.
居士阶段大概到五十岁的时候，他就开始退休，然后到行脚僧这个阶段，不开始工作，不用开始工作了。
Right, that is called Vanaprastha.
这个被称为 Vanaprastha.
And then the final stage is sannyas, where one is traveling and preaching.
然后到萨尼亚西气绝的这个阶段，他开始旅行和传播。
So sannyas is not necessary for everyone.
Sannyas 对每个人来说不是必须的。
But people who have purified their heart, if the one has purified the heart enough, then he can take up the renounced order of life and take up the missionary work full time, preaching.
如果一个人内心足够受到净化的话，他可以全职做这个奉献服务，全然的退下来，全身心的投入到这个奉献服务之中。
Mm-hmm. So the when one is grihastha, then one will take up one of the varnas. One will either be Brahman, or Kshatri, or Vaishya, or Sudra.
Varna 就是根据他的这个品质，他有可能是 Kshatriya, Vaishya, or Sudra.
And so the grihasthas, they're meant to maintain the other ashrams.
Grihastha, 居士阶段是要维系其他的，是要维系其他的这个阶段的这个人的。
The brahmacharis and the vanaprasthas and the sannyasis.They don't have any income.
真守身 sannyasi, 还有 vanaprastha, 他们是没有收入的。
But the people in the grihastha life, they're supposed to earn some money, make some income.
但是居士阶段，他应该赚一些钱，有一些收入。
So some people are Brahmins.And some people are Kshatriyas, and some are Vaishya, and some are Sudra.
在这个居士阶段，有一些人是 Brahma, 有一些人是 Vaishya, 有一些人是 Sudra, 有一些人是 Kshatriya.
So they help each other, they work together.
所以他们相互的帮助，一起合作。
Yeah.
Whether the Brahmana can be.Sannyasi.
Yes, Brahmanas are meant to be the sannyasis.
是的，一个婆罗门应该要成为一个 sannyasi.
Brahmanas, that is the qualification to be sannyasi, that you're a good Brahmana.
Brahmana, Gurudev.
If you're a good Brahmana, then you can become a sannyasi.
如果你是一个好的婆罗门的话，你应该成为一个 sannyasi。
你可以成为一个 sannyasi。
你可以成，如果你是一个好的婆罗门的话，你可以成为 sannyasi。
There are some sampradayas, just like if you are in the Mayavadi, the Shankaracharya line, to take sannyas, you have to be a brahmana.
在这个 Shankaracharya。的这个传系之中，如果你是一个 sannyasi 的话，你必须是婆罗门。
You have to be born in a Brahmana family to become a sannyasi.
你应该在婆罗门的家庭之中出生，才成为一个 sannyasi.
But in the Vaishnava line, that's not necessary.
但是在 Vaishnava 的传承之中，出生在婆罗门家庭，这个并不是必要的条件。
But you have to be a brahmana. Maybe you're not brahmana by birth, but you can be a brahmana by work and by quality.
我们不是通过这个出生而成为 brahmana. 我们是通过活动以及品质而成为 brahmana.
So Lord Chaitanya, he was born in a brahmana family.And he took sannyas.
主 Chaitanya, 他是出生在一个 Brahmana 的家庭，然后接受了 sannyas.
And he took sannyas in the line of Shankaracharya.
他是在 Shankaracharya 的这个传系之中接受的 sannyas 的启迪。
But he was a Vaishnava.
但是他又是一位奉献者 Vaishnava.
And Prabhupada, Prabhupada, he was not born in a Brahmana family. And we see Bhaktivinoda Thakur also is not from a Brahmana family. But they're the greatest Brahmanas. And they're the greatest devotees.
但是他们是最伟大的 Brahmana, 婆罗门。
Okay, 还有问题吗?
没有了。
Okay, all right. So we thank all the devotees for their questions. Women Ganshi Fungshenza, Ganshi Nimadwenti, Ganshi Subudi Rai, Gibwaman Jingtai Defani, Ganshi Sati, Juju, Ganshi Sara Fungshenza, Juhu Niman, Changsong Bien Kwaila, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Jai.
Go back to Vrinda Ki.
Jai.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.